So the first thing to know about insomnia is that it's a subjective complaint. So that means that the most integral piece of the diagnostic criteria is the complaint of dissatisfaction. So the complaint of dissatisfaction with sleep quantity or quality associated with either difficulty falling asleep, difficulty staying asleep, or waking up too early. And these sleep disturbances have to cause significant distress or impairment in at least one domain of functioning. And these disturbances happen about half the nights or more, and they last at least 3 months. And this last point is very important. The disturbances are not attributable to an obvious other cause, like a substance or another psychiatric or medical condition.
Jay, do you know what I don't see on that slide?
What don't you see?
A certain amount of hours per night.
Right.
That's not on there.
How interesting is that?
Wow.
And we also don't see how long does it take for someone to fall asleep.
Right.
Or how long you're awake during the night. So in a way, insomnia is in the eye of the beholder.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
That's good.
So if you have a patient that takes 20 minutes to fall asleep, but they're really upset about this and they don't function well during the day and they think it's all because they take so long to fall asleep, that's insomnia.
Yep.
But if someone takes 2 hours to fall asleep, but they're not really worried and they're fine, they don't feel it during the day, that's not insomnia.
That's normal for me.
Yeah. Is that normal for you?
Well, not me personally. I'm just saying, you know, if a patient says that's normal, then that's not it.
Yeah. Exactly. Now, just because it's subjective doesn't mean it's not very real. Insomnia is very prevalent. So just matching exactly what you see in your clinics, about a third to up to half of the adult population have significant insomnia symptoms. And about 5 to 15% have insomnia that meets diagnostic criteria. And just as important as knowing what insomnia is what it isn't. So have you heard people talking about insomnia and sleep deprivation interchangeably, right? From your patients, perhaps from the media, even from ourselves, we throw these terms around. But it's really important to know that chronic insomnia and sleep deprivation are actually very different concepts. There is some overlap, but they are separate. And it's important to know the difference because the treatments for those can be the opposite. So I'll tell you why. Let's start with sleep deprivation. This sleep deprivation is when someone doesn't have enough opportunity to sleep. So think of a single mom working 3 jobs, and she only has 5 hours to lay down each night. That's called sleep deprivation. She doesn't have enough opportunity to sleep. Or there are other environmental or social barriers or poor sleep habits, or you know, if any of you have kids that are teenagers or college students that are pulling all-nighters to study or to party, then yeah, that's also sleep deprivation, right? While on the other hand, chronic insomnia is not that. That's when someone has plenty of opportunity to sleep and their sleep environment and their sleep behaviors are generally pretty good, and yet they still have trouble falling or staying asleep. And their sleep troubles are due to psychophysiological hyperarousal and or insufficient sleep drive. So that's not an external source of not being able to sleep, that's more internal.